Okay, everybody, Red Viking Trucker, man, the night before Christmas and all through the house, nothing was moving except Red Viking Trucker and the guest he has on tonight's show. This is the second interview tonight because people have made time out of their busy schedules to get on this call with me and help you in your journey, and you're looking into the business for whether this business will be a good fit. And what's cool about this interview I have for you, this second interview tonight, I have on the phone Miss Lynn with us tonight. Let me tell you, Miss Lynn, she and I had a good pre-interview, and I've talked to so many women thinking about this business that are petrified of making the move, and yet Miss Lynn has done that. She came from a corporate background. She's been every level of management, and her children are out of the house now, so she had some freedom for herself, and she actually said, you know what, it was time for me to reinvent myself and start over and get me a do-over. And I hear that so much from everybody I speak to about jumping in this business. So we're going to understand on this interview tonight why this business may be a great fit for some women that have the personality for it and have the demeanor for it. And you're going to hear it firsthand because she's in her first or second week of driving solo now after working her way through school. Miss Lynn, are you with us on the line?
Yes, I am, Red. I'm here.
I appreciate you making the time this evening on Christmas Eve very much. Kind of, if you would, fill the listeners in for the things maybe I didn't flesh out or cover about your background prior to jumping in the truck business and why you even thought about truck driving.
Okay, so what happened was I was in the corporate world and I just felt, you know, my child had left the house a couple years before. I was divorced and I really wanted a do-over. I really wanted to reinvent myself and I wanted to do something totally outside the box, and I like driving. I love being by myself. I'm very independent. So I said, you know, what can I do that meets all those needs but will still grant me as much as I was making as an accountant in the corporate world? And so I thought about truck driving because I love driving. I love being by myself. And I think that it speaks to my personality, and I think that if a woman wants to get into this, they have to have an independent personality. They have to be flexible. They have to be a creative solution solver, and they have to be determined to the point that they absolutely refuse to give up, and they're going to push through things and just make it work. And so all of that, you know, spoke to me. Now, I think, too, for women, they need to understand that this is not a job. This is a lifestyle, and it makes a big commitment. So prior to all of this, I had a child at home. I had a senior citizen father that I, you know, multiple medical problems and stuff like that. So at that point in my life, it was not a good fit because if something happened with my father, I'd have to drop everything in the corporate world and deal with that. In trucking, you don't have that ability because you're usually working 7 days a week.
Yeah, you don't have that ability.
There's not a whole lot of time for crises in your life. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this. What was the turning point, and what was the final impetus for you to turn left and get into the trucking business? If you could name one thing, because again, most women, and I don't want to sound sexist at all, but I know in how I was raised and being around, you know, my wife, no matter how much us guys want to say we participate in the household, you guys really are the heartbeat of the house. You're the heartbeat of, you know, everything that happens. Then if you're working outside the house, you have that going on. Plus you have just the natural nurturing instinct to try and create a nest. And then you're leaving all of that, like your son's, you know, now he's out of the house and you have some freedom. What was the biggest fear you had jumping into that seat? What was the biggest number one fear you had that a woman listening to this might go, you know what, that's my fear too?
Could I do it? Could I learn what I needed to learn to do it? Could I physically have the physical strength to do it? Because, Red, as you and I discussed, I'm driving doubles. So when you're putting together those doubles and tearing them apart, you do have the dolly in there, and you are moving that 3,300 piece of equipment. So that was one thing. The other thing was, you know, wow, I'm really going to be on my own. And yes, I'm independent, but this is going to push that independence envelope because whatever goes wrong, whatever decision I have to make, it's on me. There's no one to call at another office and say, hey, how do you do this kind of thing? I mean, yes, there are other truck drivers I can call. The camaraderie that I have experienced is by far the best that I've ever had in any corporate environment or any other industry, from yard jockeys to other drivers, they're just tremendous. And, just being by myself, I think, because, with women, we're always in a secure environment, and security was a big issue for me, And like I said, I'm in an LTL, less than a load company, so if I am out overnight, they put me up in a hotel. So I'm not at a truck stop, and I don't have to worry about that security.
That's kind of cool. I've not heard of companies doing that. That's kind of cool. You have a little bit more security and a little bit more safety. That's good.
Absolutely. Safety was a big issue for me. I think I can handle myself, but why be put in any strange situations where I may have to?
In all honesty, too, I mean, going to a truck stop, you really, as I know from driving doubles this last week, you really have no option to back that vehicle up into a slot. So if you can't find a place to pull in straight, you're not going to be parking it. So you kind of kill two birds with one stone. If you can park at a hotel someplace and just park, parallel to the road and just keep on moving the next morning, because there's no backing in these doubles. That doesn't happen.
You're right.
Well, let me ask you this. Now, in your journey into the trucking business, you had a little bit of a glitch. You had a little bit of a blip in your journey because you came in with one company and then you bumped into a lot of, we'll just call it male chauvinism, where these guys didn't know how to deal with a woman that they were teaching. And I see that a lot in some of these. As a matter of fact, in my CDL school, one of their newest instructors was fired because he was just horrible to women. And he had been there about 6, 7 weeks, 8 weeks, and they had a real big backlog of classes, and mainly females in those classes, because he just couldn't relate to them. And he was telling me, so go back to their other job and go back to, what they used to do and don't even think about trucking. It was all whatever the anger was about it he had in his life, it was coming out in how he taught. And he didn't help the women in the class see past, like you said, can I do it? Am I strong enough? Am I able to do it? He actually amplified their fears by how he spoke to them. And you had some of that too.
Yeah, I can actually say that, yes, I knew the trucking industry was male-dominated. I knew it was a rough and tough and tumbling environment. What I didn't expect, Red, was I didn't understand the male bonding and how they kind of harass each other and kid each other. And that's fine from male to male, but from a female perspective, because we're a little bit more soft and kinder and peacemakers and try to, collaborate and get along with everyone. When that was, I thought I would be exempt because I'm a female. No, I was not exempt. It was directed at me. So from my standpoint, it was like I was being harassed every day. You don't know how to back up, every day. Really no sensitivity training from the guy's standpoint. They would say whatever they wanted to me, like, you can't back up. Oh, you came from a corporate background? Well, you really don't know nothing, do you? I mean, this is every day, all day long. Every time they walked up to a new person, she wants to be an over-the-road trucker. What is she thinking? And hey, the girl can't even back up. Well, I'm only the second day into having my CDL. I mean, how far do you think, how good do you think I really am at that point? Give me a break, That was tough. That was really tough. And the weirdest and most bizarre thing, Red, about this was that the two, because I had multiple trainers, and the two trainers that I had issues with, when I finally lost it and took them aside and really chewed them out and set them straight on how their behavior was inappropriate, and I had enough, suddenly, like the next day, it was like that never happened, and I was great and wonderful, and, got all this support from them, and suddenly I'm doing everything right, and I thought, this is really bizarre. Why do I have to lose my temper and tell them and really just tell them off, and then suddenly I gain all this respect from them? That is so bizarre to me.
Yeah, believe me, I coming from my abusive background and watching my mother deal with my stepfather, I completely, when you're speaking, I can completely give you the whole dynamic. So I understand what you're saying. And it starts with bullshit like that, pardon my language. It starts with that little subtle stuff that they start doing and saying to you. You surviving and getting through that is so powerful. Now, you went from that company. What was the next step?
Okay, so the first company that I went to, basically, because I failed my CDL, because they failed to teach me how to back up correctly. They terminated my contract, right? So then what happened was they put that on my DAC report. And when they put that on my DAC report, my second choice suddenly refused to accept my application, even though they had previously accepted me. So then I went with this other company who did accept me. And in order for
let me stop you there. Let me see, because you covered a lot of great information we need to kind of stop and look at. You did. Because first and foremost, you said that in the pre-interview, you told me about how that these companies, they have this non-compete, and this other company, because of what happened in this DAC report, they actually limited you with your job search.
They did, because what I was told by my current company, the training manager there, was that it said, look, let me tell you how the industry looks at this, right, wrong, or indifferent. If you fail out of a school, they either think, A, you did not have the skills and could not learn the skills, or they think that you had some type of attitude issue, or worse yet, they determine that on some level you were emotionally disturbed, or, you know, something was off
right.
about you, you know. And, of course, in my
right.
case, none of that was true.
Right. Now, let me also, because you had also mentioned this is a great point, and I haven't really discussed this in my interviews or in my channel at all. The DAC report, you actually said that there's a way to pull that DAC report on yourself right online. Could you give the listeners maybe the link or how to go do that?
I don't have the link handy, but I was told by another truck driver that it was all big secret and that you would never know it was on it. But I actually did the research, and I don't know if it's DAC.com or something like that, but you actually can go out there, and for free, you just call them up and give them your information, and about 2 to 3 weeks later, they do send you a report. And the only thing that was on my report is the fact that the first company was listed on there. But obviously, since I don't have a CDL, it's very clear to all the other companies, well, obviously she failed out.
Right, right. And I'm going to look that up, and I'll try and put the link in the description of this video. Let me also, you know, kind of from the female standpoint, if you were to give the women listening that are out there that are 23 years old to 65 years old, coming out of whatever they're coming out of, and from any background, because you have a degree, just like I do. You're out here, you know, doing this business that doesn't require a degree. You're out here doing this with a degree. What would be the top one, two, or three things you would tell the listeners, especially the female listeners, that are looking for another way to succeed in life because maybe they've hit a wall, and just like you, they're like, you know what, I've done everything I was supposed to do to this point in my life, and now I want to reinvent myself. What would you tell them?
I would tell them that regardless of where you're at, if you want to be in what I consider a stable work environment, because I've been downsized 4 times by corporate America, that I think the trucking industry is very stable, that you're always going to find a job in any location. I think that, yes, it does take some work, but I think any woman can do what I'm doing. And the money is there, because one of my requirements was that I had to make at least as much money as I did in the corporate world, and I believe I will make that in the first year.
It
is lucrative. And Red, as you and I talked about, with my company, we don't have owner-operators. I'm working strictly for the company on their equipment, and my average take-home is about $800 a week.
And let me ask you this, too, because I remember my first dispatch, once I got my own truck and you're kind of, you know, sent off into the wild blue yonder. What was that like with all the doubts you had initially, you know, about can you do it? Are you strong enough or whatever else? What was that like when you first got your first solo dispatch? Even though you've been trained, even though you've been taught everything, you're still being sent out in the wild blue yonder on your own. What was that like?
Let me tell you, the first day, I can tell you, my first thought was, I don't know anything. I mean, when you get in the truck by yourself and there's no one there to guide you, that's when the education begins, because
right.
you're making all the decisions, you know, and it's my biggest concern that day was, am I going to get lost? All right.
Right. Right. I know.
Didn't get lost, but I tell you what, I had quite a few fights with my dolly, which is the connecting part between the two trailers, the two 27 footers, and it
Yeah.
gave me fits. That, and I'm thinking, wait, I'm kind of a chunky girl, right? Between my weight and my strength, I should be able to do that, right? Well, I had to reposition,
Yeah.
you know, the truck a couple times, and it was just the odd things like that that I had not anticipated that took ate up my day and took time away from me. But it's doable, you know.
And let me ask
Everything
you
had
this
a
too, because
solution.
let me ask you this too, because you're so well spoken, you're so aware of who you are. I love that. With where you are right now, how good do you feel about yourself? With where you are right now with this business and what you've come through in your life and what you've survived and now you're out here doing this, how do you feel about yourself?
You know, I think I've always been a confident person and I've always been able to overcome, but I tell you what, driving a truck is an awesome thing, all right? And I feel very good about myself. I feel very accomplished. Not to say the corporate world was great, but this is a whole different beast, and every day is new. Even if I'm going to the same place, the traffic is different every day. There's always something that's different every day that keeps you on top of your game and keeps your attention, and it's just exciting. It's just really exciting, and you're just stretching your abilities every day in this industry and learning
It's almost,
every day.
yeah, at least for me, it's almost been like, and again, I came from a very, very successful background. This for me is almost everything you're saying. I enjoy the solitude. I enjoy having to hustle. I enjoy having to be responsible for everything that happens during the day. But it is such a satisfaction to know that, you know what, I can do it. I can drive an 18-wheeler. I can handle this thing in cities. I can handle this thing in small country roads. I can handle this thing on the highway.
Yep.
And as a driving doubles, and I'll say this to the folks who are listening, because I drove doubles this first week here, there is no backing with doubles. You better have every turn you make, it better be a good turn, because there is no backing up with the double. And in your case, your company actually gives you a hotel for the night because they don't want to put you at a truck stop, and which actually serves two purposes. You don't have to worry about backing up because you can pull in like parallel to some
right.
of the roads and park.
Right.
But you also have that security because you're in a hotel every night versus a truck stop as a female. But
right.
at the end of the day, you know what? Your story is so powerful to women listening that have to hear it and also understand that there's another solution out there. As crazy as it sounds, because truck driving at least, and I'm going to let you get one more word in here, but it's almost like getting in the covered wagon and driving to California and staking your claim and going, we're just going to make it, because
right.
you're responsible for everything. And there's a courage in that. There's a courage in that for the male side of the business, female side of the business, there's a courage that you just can't describe till you do it, because once you start to drive an 18-wheel truck, you have permanent job security. You can go anywhere in the U.S. and get a job. You can take that knowledge and become, like, you can go from doubles now to tankers to whatever else you want to do because you know how to handle the tractor. Everything else you can be taught. And that's just a cool place to be psychologically. And then you also have the satisfaction. For me, this is a very satisfying job. There's no stress other than stress I put on myself. And I don't know if you feel the same way, but there's no real stressors during the day other than the stress I put on either, you know, how I perceive traffic, how I perceive the dropping and hooking. Everything else
That's
is just
true.
What I make it. Yeah.
And the other thing, too, is, you know, you're really not out there alone. You know, I'm very humbled every day, especially, you know, as a new truck driver, that whether it's the yard jockeys or other truck drivers, now that I'm out there on my own, I mean, they are so helpful. And they're willing to do whatever they can to aid me or help me in any way. And it's just heartwarming, the camaraderie that there is in the trucking industry, regardless of whether it's a yard jockey or whether it's another truck driver. And even truck drivers that are not with my company have helped
Right.
me.
I agree completely. Well, listen, we're getting close to the 19-minute mark, Ms. Lynn. I appreciate, again, on Christmas Eve, no less, you taking a moment to stop your evening and make this call available to all the listeners. There's a lot of value in this call for the women out there that no matter what you've gone through, no matter what you think about what you've been told, who you've been told you are, what your husband, your ex-boyfriend told you are, you can redefine, reinvent, and recommit yourself and start and get a do-over. You get a do-over every day in this business. You can start fresh every day and do something different. And I love that you saw that and that you, and at least from me looking from the male side of the business to the female side of the business, that you saw that and you made that change and it's working out for you and you actually enjoy it. That's so cool to hear.
Well, Red, I appreciate you. I appreciate all the interviews you're doing with different aspects of the business and just the knowledge and the information you're sharing with everybody to help them understand the industry, you know, and encourage them to take that initial jump, because you were one of the people who I looked towards, you know, when I was making that decision. So I appreciate you greatly.
That's very humbling for you to tell me that. I appreciate that, Ms. Lynn. And again, thank you for making the time this evening. Folks, if you're watching this interview, none of us are getting out of here alive. Why don't you start tomorrow? Reinvent yourself. And don't let society define who you are, what you are. Don't let your ex-boyfriend, your ex-girlfriend, your ex-husband, your ex-wife, don't let anybody define who you are. Who are you? You figure it out. You make your move and start moving towards what is best for you. Because you know what? I've had a saying since I've been in the online world. I've been in the online world since way back in the late 90s. You know, you have to fail fast and figure out fast what works and what doesn't work. And this business of truck driving, for the women out there listening, listen to Ms. Lynn tell her story. You can reinvent yourself. You can start over. You can rebuild, and you can have a lot of satisfaction in that. Would you agree with that, Ms. Lynn?
Absolutely, Red, I would.
Thank you again for making the time, darling. And listen, folks, please subscribe, like, comment, and share. And if you like the videos, support the channel. Download our Cars Are Pro app. You see the link, or actually the name up here, the website down here. It's on iTunes, Google Play, whole separate business. But download that, support the channel. If you're reaching out for help, you can reach me at the email address above or the phone number below. Always download the app first. People like Ms. Lynn on Christmas Eve taking a moment to share their knowledge and pass it on. Huge. And I'm humbled that people want to do that on my channel. Ms. Lynn, you have a great Christmas. I hope Santa's good to you tomorrow morning.
Thank you so much, Red. You too.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.